So those are the main templates I used. We'll give you all of this code so you can reference it in future stuff. And then here's the CSS I used to actually style the whole page. We don't cover much CSS in this class, but you can, you know, learn from what I've done here. On the body tag, I basically set the font to be Helvetica, font size 14. You know, I set the width to be 800. This margin, basically, this is a trick for centering content. Add a little padding, make the color slightly off black, you know, 333 instead of 000. We define, when we use H2, we set the font size as 24, bold, some space on the bottom. That's what margin bottom does. Errors are red. Labels, we can make it a block element, font size 20. This says if a label follows another label, put some space in between them, 20 pixels. This input type text formats our text box. So we make it width 500 pixels, font size 20. A little padding inside the box that just kind of spaces things out a little bit. I use a monospace font for entering text. You know, it makes it look like you're writing on a typewriter or something. Text area, again, I make it 500 pixels so it matches the input. Make it 400 pixels tall so we get a nice actual box. 17 pixels font. I'll make our submit button a little bigger. This is the main title of the page where it says CS253. That's size 40 text. It's bold, it's centered, it's got some space below it. And it's actually a link to the front of the blog, but I don't want to underline there, which is what HTML does by default when you have links. So we can say text decoration none, which turns off that underline. This says 15 pixels between two blog posts. Post heading. Now, this is the actual title of a particular blog post. So we've got that name. This adds that border, that line on the bottom. Position relative is used for something else, which I'll show you in a sec. Title, bold, 24 pixels tall. The date the blog was submitted. This is position absolute. What position absolute lets you say is we want to position this 0 pixels from the right edge of our parent if that parent is position relative, which is why we have position relative here, and 0 pixels from the bottom of that parent. In this case, we're making it color 999, which is kind of gray. So if we were to go back into our browser, this whole thing is the blog heading. This is the title. And this is that created date, which is position absolute, which is positioning 0 pixels from the right and 0 pixels from the bottom. And that's how we position that over here nicely on the right. And it's color 999, which is gray. And so that's just some basic CSS. I think there's just a little bit more. Content, the post content has 5 pixels on the top. That separates it from its heading a little bit. You can see we've got that big text here. When I mouse over it, you can see my cursor turns into a little hand, which means it's a link, but I got rid of that underline. And then you can see all the fonts we used here and the border bottom we added here to make this line and then the text into these posts. You know, you don't have to understand that. You don't need to do it in any of our homeworks because we can't grade easily the appearance of your things. But I like to do it so it looks, you know, slightly nicer, and so I figured I'll show you how I did that. That is it for homework 3. That was actually quite a bit. If you made it this far, good job. You are writing some serious web applications now.